My name is Omkar Kere, and I'm doing Design Engineering Master's Program from Skilling. This is my SolidWorks final project, and its name is Design and Assembly of a Truck. So abstract of this project, in this project, parts of a truck are designed using SolidWorks, and the parts are then assembled using SolidWorks assembly. Then I give an appropriate appearance to the part, and the final product is rendered using PhotoView 360 as well as the SolidWorks Visualize. So introduction, as we know, a truck is used for many purposes like moving or transporting materials like rock, etc. So in this project, I have designed a dump truck. It has a bucket which pivots and drops the load. A hydraulic piston is used to lift the bucket. And here I have designed a cabin, chassis, wheel, dump bucket, lid, fuel tank, front and rear axle, tail lamps, right, and the steering knuckles. And SolidWorks is a 3D modeling software which is used for modeling 3D parts in industries like automobile, aerospace, and it is parametric modeling software. So I can actually update my models in the assembly anytime. Like if I want to make some changes to the model, that's what parametric means. And then I give the material or the object can be changed to give an appropriate appearance. And then PhotoView 360 is an image rendering software, which is adding built-in SolidWorks to make high quality images. So these are the tools and features that are used for making this project, such as sketch, line, spline, loft, split, extrude bolt, extrude cut, revolve, swept, and all the surface features, lane, mirror, and circular pattern, linear pattern, chamfer. So yeah, this is the cabin. These are the tools and features used to make this. So this is where the control of the entire truck is, from acceleration to controlling the dump bucket, etc. This is the dump bucket where the entire load is carried, and these are the features used. So this has a hydraulic piston which will lift it up, and it will pivot at this point. This is the chassis, and these are the features used for chassis. All the entire parts are assembled on this chassis. This is a lid that will go behind the dump bucket to close it. These are the wheels of the truck. The features used are sketch, chamfer, extrude cut, extrude bolts. This is the rear axle of the truck. This is just a representation of rear axle. This is the front axle. It has this holes for the steering knuckle. And this is also a representation. This is a steering knuckle. So here I connect a rod which is connected to the steering, and this will rotate about this cylinder. And these are the features that I have used. This is the door. So I made this door using the split function from the cabin. This is a leaf spring. So the main purpose of the spring is to suspend the wheels and to keep them on the ground, as well as to smoothen the ride of the truck and like absorb all the vibration from the of the truck. This is the fuel tank. So these are the features used, and I have used the shell feature to make it empty from inside. This is the exhaust of the truck to remove the burned gases. This is a tie rod for steering mechanism. And this is a rack gear for steering mechanism. I made it using a linear pattern and extrude bolts. This is a pinion gear which will fit on the rack gear for steering. And yeah, this is the steering wheel. And this is the representation of the universal joint here and here. This will connect over here, and it will spin at an angle. And these are the rods and pins which I have used for steering to make the mechanism for steering. And this is my hydraulic piston, which will lift the bucket. So yeah, this is the assembly of the truck. This is how the truck looks on final assembly. And these are the mates used, concentric, coincident, parallel. with distance, etc. This is the exploded view of my truck. So rendered images in this, I have rendered using PhotoView 360. I have used a environment urban one. So this is how it looks in PhotoView 360. And using SolidWorks Visualize, this is how it looks. This is a gravel pit environment. And this is this environment, I have used a backplate environment. So conclusion is that I have designed parts and I have assembled the parts in the SolidWorks. I gave appropriate assembly, appropriate appearance, and I have rendered using PhotoView 360 as well as Visualize. So in future, I will be adding differentials in the axial as they are just representation right now, but I will try to add differentials. I will also improvise on the steering mechanism to make it more realistic, and also improvise on the interior of the cabin, such as dashboard and seats. So yeah, this is the improvisation I will make in future.